Today's video will be sponsored by ICM. They sent the kit for review. They are a new channel sponsor. Remember, as always, I accept $0 from viewers, from sponsors, from anybody. I pay for everything myself, but I do get kits for free to review, and that means that it is an unbiased review. We can have a lot of fun with it. We welcome ICM out of Eastern Europe, has been sending me kits, and we're going to build up their 1/24th scale Model T 1913 Speedster, and this one has cool drivers in it, a lady behind the wheel and her assistant showing her the way. He's like, yeah, man, you take that right down to that corner there, man. You hit that handbrake, you tap the throttle, you'll kick the back end out of this thing. We'll do some awesome power slides, baby. And that's what they're doing. So I'm going to be building it up. Now, I have a really unique idea for this build, so I want you to take a look at it, and we'll see how you think at the end. They've got gorgeous molding, all gray plastic. It's a nice stiff styrene, but not so stiff that it snaps easily. Nice looking, excellent detail. Check out the hubs on that. ICM is widely known as a military model manufacturer, and they make some exquisite models that you're going to be seeing from me, whether they are unboxings or they are full builds. Check out the detail on that seat, the subtle molding of an actual seat cover. Look at the tiny little molding on there. Now, like I said, this is 1/24th scale. We got awesome little windshield frames, steering boxes, floors for the vehicle. Check out the Ford logos molded into that. And these are all modern kits, so they are molded with the highest amount of detail. Look at the little door handles, the light frames. Check out that radiator. Everything has positive mounting locations. See the big squares like that? You can glue everything together. Beautiful windshield frame. Now, a lot of these parts won't be used because Model T parts on the different kits are used on different vehicles. This one will be from 1913. One big tree here. There aren't a ton of parts in it because there aren't a ton of parts in a Model T. We got nice separate frames. We've got a single large fender assembly with the chassis built in. No worrying about building it straight anymore. Look at the detail on that cylinder head, on the engine engine bottom, block halves. Look at these. Check that out. Super tiny. Little handles and clasps for the hood. Differential. See how they surround these super small parts? We got our hood here with hinges. We've got exhaust detail, fan. Single piece exhaust on that, molded as one. Excellent, excellent detail on the brakes and levers. Let's switch to the other side of the table. We've got six tires, four for the vehicle, one for a spare, and a free extra, molded in that old school white, and it is a very rubbery texture. They're definitely not vinyl. Get six of those. There is no name imprinted on the side. They have very minimal tread. They will require some sanding. There is some flash on that rubber style material. We've got two clear parts trees, though a lot of this will not be used on this model, but they still need to include the lenses for the lanterns, the headlights on this tree. Look at how clear that is. Awesome. I just love these super modern kits, and the windshield for this model right there is its own little separate part. And then this one includes two figures, and you gotta see how amazing. That's her little flowery hat. There's her face, the gloved hands, her bodice, or whatever you would call it, her beautiful blouse, top of the dress. Look at this guy. He's like, oh, you're going like a bat out of Hades. He's got it just like the box art. Amazing molding. They make some pretty awesome military figures as well. And that's everything that's in the box, okay? There are no decals because this is all hand-painted detail on the real one. There are no decals to lay on there. There's nothing on there to do that. So I'm going to get to building mine. We'll be right back. Positioning myself into sub-assembly territory. You can see we've got the main chassis ready with the seats and the floor pan. We'll look at that in a second. We've got that nice little four banger. Check out all the awesome-tastic details on that little mini engine. The molding is really top-notch, and it's exactly what you'd expect from a modern kit. You want a lot of detail, you want a lot of precise fits, and nothing passed up, and that's exactly what ICM delivers. We got the nice little luggage rack on the back, the cargo rack even's got little hinges in it, all glued together. We've got the fuel tank behind the seats, the safest place, you know, right next to you where you want it, with the beautiful Ford emblems engraved, the cap on it, all that. We got it on the trees. We can get it painted up. We've got the spare tire, or the spare wheel mount there that'll go on the back of the vehicle. I've got one of the radiator hoses here. Little tiny itsy bitsy pieces, even in 1/24th scale. The fan and pulley system is extremely simple. Glued them together. I'll clip it in, spray it, and then I can just clip off the ends and touch up the paint when I do so. That's how I do everything. I've got the firewall and its cowl all set up. We will go ahead and get that painted a brass color and then detail it from there. Now, you can go a lot of different ways with these. These little Speedsters were customized by the owners. They were repainted. They were shined up. They had brass stuff added to them. So do what you want to do with it. We got the wheels. I cut most of the trees free so I can get the wheels painted up and detailed on mine. Now, I'm going to be weathering mine up and stuff. We got the exhaust system. Nice little manifold there. Goes down to the exhaust. It's two pieces, but when you glue them together, they look absolutely outstanding. Nice, super, such super fine details. On the figures, well, actually, check it out. This is the moto meter. This has two pieces to it alone. Makes the little assembly that'll go on top of the radiator. We can paint that up and then hand detail it, cut it free, and touch it up. We've got the arms for the two people, the lady and the man. Now, these have to be positioned once the car is in position and the figures are installed, and then we can glue them on permanently. His hand was two pieces, and with a little bit of glue, it's just beautiful. No issues with that. So we'll put those on the side, get it all primed. We've got the lady with her big hat. This the head and the hat alone were like six pieces with the scarves blowing in the wind. We got her dress coming down together. Around the back, she'll be sitting in a chair, so we don't need to have backs of legs. But we got the little booties. All little detail on the booties there. She's going to go in. She's going to be the driver of the rod with her feet on the pedals. Oh, and she crashed off the side. Too much persimmon wine this week. We got the guy in the passenger seat. Check out the facial expressions, the separate goggles, the beautiful outfit. All looks nice, all glued together. Not worrying about the seam or anything because it's all going to be in a seat, glued into place. He'll be sitting in like that, so I don't worry about a lot of stuff I can't see. Or if the seams are very small, we just call it a clothing seam. We've got the little the little rubber bulb to the horn back there with an extra part we're not using in this kit. The steering column and assembly. Look at all the detail in that. All the little levers to adjust the timing and the fuel and the throttle. We got the mount. This is for the windshield. I glued that all together with model glue. We've got a total of the steering shaft, the brass rod around it, the little handles, and the windshield frame. All go into that one assembly, glued together, ready to paint up as is. This little brass tank that sits on the footwell next to the driver is all assembled. We've got the two giant headlights assembled, ready to go. We got the three lanterns, two on either side of the car, and one in the back, and we got the other part of the horn. I'm going to be able to spray this and paint it all a brass color or a shiny metallic gold. They're going to look like brass either way when they're weathered, but those are beautiful assemblies, and even though they're small, they go together well. We got some parts here we're not going to be using, but we've got an upper radiator hose. We've got the steering wheel glued together from two parts. You can see it. We've got our hood. We've got our hood hinge in the center, so it looks like it flips up. We got our crank, and we got some little release levers on either side for the engine there that we'll paint up and attach with super glue later. Get the chassis over here. We'll put the seat back roughly where it's going to go. Just roughly where it's going to go when we get it all assembled. Those seats are beautiful. We can stick them to our paint area on the bottom, get those sprayed, and then weather those up. Two nice seats. They look like real fabric seats, too. I just love that. We got the interior. Once again, we can just hold on to it with this little bit of a tree, paint it, snip that off, touch up our paint. I put the pedals in place and the brake lever. Wanted to make sure that I didn't have any problems gluing those on. We got a really nice texture on the floorboard there. Underneath, I like to number my parts. You'll see that number 13, the number 3. So I make sure I get them correct left and right. The paint covers those without issue. And then we've got the large chassis assembled. I did put the headlight mounts on because those were very tricky. Got our radiator in there. We'll have to do some hand painting on that if we want it to be brass. We got our steering box, which connects down to a beautiful set of linkages, tie rods, and everything, and the mount for the front end, and our mounts and differential in the back all go in tightly. We'll be able to drop our engine in place and start putting our hood and our firewall. We'll use super glue for the final assembly, but you can see how detailed that is. I always like to glue everything in place solidly with model glue. I will go in with a knife and take off these little nubs now that everything is dried and solid. We got excellent detail on that kit, just beautiful. So I am going to go hit the paint booth and you can come with.
Thank you.
check out my progress. I'm almost ready for the final reveal. Been weathering and beating things up, and you can see that extensively in other reviews as well, and with some of the stuff I covered here. Now, the steering wheel and the glass, the little mini windshield, is really fine assembly. Goes together nicely. I use Mod Podge gloss to hold the glass on. It fits into a nice channel and looks good. Then we glue the steering wheel on. That steering column must be placed in gently after the figures are in if you're going to use the figures. I left their arms off when I primed them so that I could position them and roughly position her near the steering wheel and all that. These are not going to be living characters that are actually driving it. I kind of want this memory to be of the first time that he was showing her how to drive a car. You can see his arm behind her on the seat like it is on the box. And they're sitting there. We're going to be painting them up. I'm going to do that off screen before I come back for the final. We're going to give them a white flat white coating. I'm going to highlight it with some blues and grays and whites so that they look like ghost figures, as you saw in the thumbnail. When we come back, I grimed up those white rubber tires just using some of the black and gray paints, just smearing them on there and getting it all decked out. But you can see just how lovely that is turning out. I got the other half of the hood here. I just haven't put it on. You can see the awesome little details in there. So far, everything is so delicate, but it actually goes together quite well. The fits have been lovely. I've hand-painted a lot of stuff. You saw me spray the bigger lights in the back with that gold tone, which looks just like brass now that we weathered it out a little bit. The grill itself, I hand-painted with the gold paint. We got the moto meter, and I gave it a little white lens on there, so it's got a little white temperature gauge on the top. So this is my idea for this build. You can check out the back. I tinted that lens with Tamiya clear red. Got the fuel tank, did some streaking of old gasoline. Did it so that it looks like it's a little damp at the bottom of the old tank too, where that gas would have evaporated and taken a bunch of metal with it as it disappeared. So we've got it all lined up, ready to go. What I've got to do is just paint those figures. There are no decals whatsoever in the kit. Paint those figures up like little ghost figures, get that steering column in there, and we're going to have my adorable little old-time diorama. I will be right back with that look. You know, great-grandma always used to talk about this guy that she knew back in the day, and he had bought a brand new 1913 Model T Speedster, and she just loved that car. And back then, teaching women to drive wasn't a very important thing for people to do. They didn't really consider it to be normal. And he was such a nice guy that he had always taught her how to drive, and they had a wonderful time. Well, 1914 came along, and this young man was sent overseas to fight the war to end all wars, World War I. He never came home. He ended up in a trench over there, and he just never came home. Well, before he left, he told great-grandma that he wanted her to keep that Speedster and take care of it and drive it around town and enjoy it. And when he got back, he would take her out to see a movie, a picture show. They might even have sound by then, and they would have a wonderful time. Well, he never came back, but she kept her promise, and she kept that 13 Speedster her entire life. And she stored it out in the old shed behind the house, and it's the only car she ever owned. And when she got too old to drive it, she just took the city bus everywhere, had the grandkids and the great-grandkids take her around. But the best part of this is great-grandma passed away, and everyone swears every now and then in the middle of the night, they'll hear the pitter-patter of an old Ford four-cylinder with a crank starter and the laughing of a young couple in love out in that shed. And the couple is together once again, going for cruises. He's teaching her how to drive. He's pointing out when you get up to that corner, you'll want to downshift and change your ignition and all that. And they just have a wonderful time riding around in their Speedster together once again, in love and enjoying themselves. Now, that's my backstory. When I saw this model and ICM sent it over, that's exactly what I thought of. I said, you know, I want to do a ghost couple, paint them in black, then some grays and blues, and then I dry brushed them with a pearlescent so that they almost look lit up in the car. I wanted to beat the car up like it had been driven and loved and used and not completely destroyed and left out in a shed. And now one of the great grandkids is going to inherit it, and hopefully they'll leave it just the way it is so that great grandpa or great grandma and her old boyfriend can ride around in it forever. So thanks to ICM for sending this kit over. There were no fit issues. It's extremely well engineered. You can see even the glass, the steering wheel, these lights that you think would be a real bear to get attached and everything. No problem at all. Beautiful wheels and tires. Absolutely correct to have that white rubber on there on a 1913. So I dirtied those up, made some oil stains on it. I dirtied up that four banger. I'll remove the hood for some pictures at the end. And it was an absolute joy to build. ICM has sent other kits. Check out my video from this previous Wednesday to see the other kits they sent that we're going to be showing on the show eventually. And as always, thanks for watching the workshop. Make sure you build your kits for you. No one else. Grab kits like this, make up your own backstories. It makes the entire build so much more fun to have a backstory behind it. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.